Hey y'all, how y'all doing? This is your girl Tashi, and I am back with another video. So we're gonna be reacting to incredible top 10 most popular UK food, okay? And UK street food. So let's get straight to it.
Each traditional British food has a story to tell, one that usually dates back centuries. From jellied eels sourced from the River Thames to
kidney pie
with mashed potatoes. If you're thinking about visiting UK anytime soon, you will want to be sure to try at least a few of these popular taste treats.
Ooh, what's that?
Today we try to know about top 10 most popular foods.
Why is it making me hungry now?
Let's begin it.
Now I'm hungry.
Number 10, sticky toffee pudding.
What?
Sticky toffee pudding, also known as STP or as sticky date pudding in Australia and New Zealand, is a British dessert consisting of a moist sponge cake made with finely chopped dates,
okay,
covered in a toffee
that
sauce,
look moist,
and often served with a vanilla custard or vanilla ice cream.
Ooh, that look good. Well, I wonder how that tastes. Comment below if you taste that before.
Lancashire hot pod is thought to have originated during the cotton industry in the 19th century. Lancashire hot pod is a stew originating from Lancashire in the northwest of England. It consists of lamb or mutton and onion, topped with sliced potatoes and baked in a heavy pot.
That look fulfilling. Oh my god, that was, ooh, that looked good. That looked delicious. I never understood people who make fun of British food. Like, their food looks so good. And people have to understand too, you know, in the UK, there's all different type of food. People are forgetting there's people who are from the Caribbeans live in the UK. There are people from India who lives in the UK. There's different people around the world that lives in the UK. So you're going to get different food, different flavor. I've seen videos of people talking about British food are so bland. Their food don't taste like it. I feel like it depends on where you're going, you know, just like here in America, people might say, oh, I don't like American food, but you know, America is a multicultural, how should I say it? Multicultural country, you know, because you have people around the world that lives here, especially in New York. I don't know about other states. Every state is different. But I know in New York, we have everybody live here. Everybody from Scotland, everybody from Mexico, doesn't matter where you're from, they live here. So they got their own restaurant here. So whatever you want to eat, you could just go down the block. If you want some Chinese food, go down the block. If you want some British food, I don't know where to go to get British food. But I'm quite sure there's a British restaurant somewhere in New York. If you're from New York, let me know where. I would like to go there. But yeah, British food look good to me. People say their food is bland. I don't know how it tastes, but from looking at these videos, food look good.
Number 8, crumpet.
Crumpet. I heard of crumpet.
Crumpets are the quintessential afternoon tea treat.
I've heard of this.
Especially when served warm with lots of butter. It's the extra yeast in the batter that creates the soft texture and delicate holes on top, perfect for soaking up jam and butter.
Ooh.
Crumpets is most popular in the United Kingdom and make frequent appearances at British tea time.
Ooh, that do look good. But what's that thing they had on top of it? Was just butter? Is that... Come on. Ooh!
Number 7. Steak and kidney pie.
I don't know about
steak
kidney.
Kidney pie is a popular British dish. It is a savory pie filled principally with a...
Now, don't get me wrong. I had kidney when I was young. My grandmother used to make some kidney. It wasn't bad because she hooked it up. She seasoned it very well. She cut it up with some onions, some red and green pepper. She hooked it up. But it's just something about it. I don't care. I'd rather liver... I can eat liver more than kidney, so yeah.
Mixture of
kidney is not my thing.
Diced kidney and onion. Its contents are generally similar to.
It has a certain smell. I don't. No. Sorry.
Number 6.
It looks good,
Sunday
but no.
Roast. A Sunday roast is a traditional British meal that is typically served on Sunday, consisting of roasted meat, roast potatoes, and accompaniments such as Yorkshire pudding, stuffing, gravy, and condiments such as applesauce, mint sauce, or red currant jelly.
That look good. Look at that. Look at that. Ooh.
Number 5.
What's
Yorkshire
that?
Pudding.
Yorkshire pudding,
pudding is a baked pudding made from a
batter. I think I've seen
eggs,
this one. I'm
flour,
not sure.
And milk or water.
I'm trying to see
a
if I remember.
British side dish. It is a versatile food that can be served in numerous ways depending on its ingredients, size, and the accompanying components
of
the meal.
It's a lot of oil.
As a first course, it can be served with onion gravy.
Onion gravy. That look good. It's a lot of oil, though. Ooh, it's a lot of oil.
Full English breakfast. A full breakfast is a substantial cooked breakfast meal, often...
I love beans. I haven't had beans in a while, but I used to make beans and toast before. And it's so crazy because I didn't know it was a British thing. I used to just make it. When I was younger, I used to just make it. No one made it for me. I probably saw it somewhere. I don't remember. And I just started making it. I was making beans. I'll make beans with toast and scrambled eggs. That was my favorite breakfast. My favorite thing to eat for breakfast.
That typically includes bacon, sausages, eggs, black pudding, baked beans, grilled tomatoes, mushrooms, and a beverage such as coffee.
That looked good.
It appears in different regional variants.
I never had blood pudding before, but that looked good. Look at that. Look at that. That's a big breakfast, though. I can't eat all that. That's too much.
Number three.
That is too much for me. It's so crazy because if I eat that much, I'll be so tired. I'll be useless. I can't go to work. I can't do anything.
Bangers and mash. Bangers and mash, also known as
bangers and mash,
is a traditional British dish consisting of sausages served with mashed potatoes.
I love onions.
It may consist of one of a variety of flavored sausages made of pork, lamb, or beef. The dish is usually served with onion gravy, but may also include fried onions and peas.
I hate green peas. It looks good, but you're going to have to take that green peas with you. I never liked green peas, and my grandma used to force me to eat it. She's like, you better eat that green peas. It's good for you. Well, it ain't good for me because I don't like it. I hate it. I don't care what you put in it. I don't care if you season it.
Number
I don't
two,
like it.
Toad in the hole.
That looked good.
Toad in the hole or sausage toad is a traditional English dish consisting of sausages in Yorkshire.
Yeah, I love sausages
batter,
a lot.
Served with onion gravy and vegetables.
Yeah, I eat a lot of sausage.
The dish has also been prepared using other meats, such as rump steak and lamb's kidney. Number one, fish and chips.
Fish and chips.
Fish and chips is a...
So crazy. I almost forgot about that. Yeah, I've heard that a lot. Fish and chips.
Popular hot dish consisting of fried fish and crispy batter, served with chips. The dish originated in England, where these two components had been introduced from separate immigrant cultures. It is not known who created the culinary fusion.
Yeah, who created that?
Aromatic British meal. Main ingredients are battered and fried fish with deep fried chips.
That looked good too. It's just simple, but it looks good.
Thank you so much.
Fish and chips. I love how the way y'all call French fries chips. That's why if I ever go to the UK, I have to always remember how to say certain things. So I can't, when I go there, I don't say fries. I say chips. But what do you call chips? Oh, crisp. Yeah, I say crisp. Right? Yes, y'all say crisp. Yes, can I have some? Do you have any crisp? I know, trying to sound British is terrible. I know it's terrible. But anyway, comment below to me how you feel about this one. And I'll see y'all later. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Y'all take care. Peace.